the combination of this phenol A and glycerol methacrylate. In 1960, traditional and macrophyll composites are developed, and in 1970, microphyll and light initiated composites. In 1980, posterior composites. In 1990, higher, slower, macro and combo composites. And in 2000, nanophyll composites are developed. This is the image showing the sequence of historical aspects related to the development of different composites. First, in between the 1950s and 1960s, the development of composites and in 1960 and 70, macrophyll composites and macrophyll composites. These are the first developed composites, that is macrophyll composites. And in 1970, at the start of 1970, acid etching and enamel bonding were formed. Acid etching is a technique which helps for the bonding of composites to the two surfaces. And now at the start of the 1980s, as many modern composites are formed, and microphyll composites global, backward, dehydrated, and recently nanohybrid and controlled shrinkage composites are also formed. These are the advantages. And this also shows different dual mechanisms and the development of different dual mechanisms. Initially, circular composites are developed, later on, individual and visible light-filled composites. That shows the sequential on the development of composites. First, we can deal with definition of composite. According to Einstein, composite is mainly defined as a highly closely polymeric material that is reinforced by dispersion of amorphous silica, glass, crystalline or organic versus filler particles and of short fibers, bonded to the metals by a coupling agent. That agent is, composite is mainly composed of three major components. The three major components are mainly amorphous silica, glass, crystalline and organic versus filler particles. These are bonded together but with the help of a coupling agent. This coupling agent will join them together and it forms a unit mass. According to Skinner, they are defined as composite versus a three-dimensional combination of two or more